Yes, you're
can
okay.
We, what,
by that time.
Can I ask you the question again? And could you condense the story slightly?
Yes.
Because it looked as though you were struggling for it. You obviously aren't. But yeah. Could we just condense again? I'll ask you the question.
Yes, right now. 2:45,
right.
Have you asked... Have you written a book about it yet?
Well, I have, actually, but it isn't published yet. Because the story of the Hess family, which, of course, is direct to Prince Charles, is absolutely fascinating. Alexander of Hess, in 1551, ran away from Russia with his sister's lady-in-waiting, who was a Polish girl, quite ordinary, very nice girl, very pretty, but she was not royal.
I think
and they tore away from the Tsar,
need
this absolutely,
moment,
because when they got to Brezhnev in Prussia,
all over
they
the
got
world,
married,
not only
which, of
England,
course, was more dramatic.
Beauty
they then went on to Hesse,
what
where his
get
brother
all
had
the time
become
on the
manager,
which is you.
And he said, well, I don't know what we're going to do about
shooting,
it.
You have to have a name.
Balance,
because, of course, she couldn't take his name, because he wasn't important enough. And they found an obscure little village up in the mountains called
Bettenberg. I think that she became the Countess of
Bettenberg.
And when she's given him three wonderful sons,
I think everybody who's coming to the wedding feels his father.
She became her Serene Highness, the Princess
the world
Bettenberg.
Represented.
And their
and
eldest
I think
son
this will give
married Queen
sort of
Victoria's daughter.
People,
and of course,
and feel
was Lord Mountbatten's
things aren't quite so bad.
Perhaps
father.
There is a rainbow around
and
the
and, of course, great uncle
for.
To Prince Charles.
And
the whole of the Battenberg-Mountbatten family came from this wild romantic story
yes,
of an elopement. Couldn't be more exciting.
Lord Mountbatten used to tease me about it. He says
he's
always a duke who marries Cinderella in the end, which is quite true.
I couldn't give advice to anyone,
because
I
think, especially young girls, the last thing
they want
is
great many.
What I think is that she's got taken on an enormous responsibility, but she does know
about
it. Everybody talks as though it's something very new to her.
My
son-in-law,
Lord
Spencer, was ADC exclusively for years.
And
they were all brought up at Sandwood.
She knows exactly
what she's
taking on.
I think that's the answer to real
love. It is different,
because
real love
must be physical and
spiritual.
She's got a wonderful husband to do it with,
because, of course,
that's tremendous.
I'm still
less says the Prince Wales.
He always said he's a very remarkable young man.
Nobody writes about spiritual
love
as well as physical.
And I think she has all the qualities
which will help him.
And that's really what people are.
She has a tremendous instinct for doing the right thing,
for being
sweet to people and understanding.
And
she's got
all
the
things we've been
good wishes and sympathy.
And love of the nation already, which is rather remarkable if you think about it, when she's only 20.